Coquina is an experiential kitchen where guests come to learn, cook under expert supervision, and dine here itself. This kitchen specializes in Awadhi cooking and often unearths some extinct and unheard recipes. In this series, our food curator, Javed, introduces you to some simple to cook recipes that can be easily replicated in modern kitchens at home.
Today I'm going to make Baida, Keema, Bheja, Aloo Tikki. It is tough aloo patties with egg, brain and mince of meat. Aloo Tikki is a traditional Indian snack. We can have it as it is with some chutney condiments, or we can have it with a topping of sorn chutney, dahi or yogurt, and can be eaten as a snacks. So let's start preparing the recipe.
To make aloo tikkis, we need about 1/2 kilo potatoes boiled. Then we will needing 2 medium sized onions finely chopped, a handful of coriander chopped, 4 to 5 green chilies chopped, 2 teaspoons of corn flour for binding, then chopped ginger, about 1/2 teaspoon of red chilies, salt to taste, 1 egg for covering, and we will cover it up with bread crumbs. To make the aloo tikki, we will take the boiled potatoes and we'll grate them. As we all know, potatoes are very starchy. So if we grate them, they don't become slimy, but when we mash them, they become slimy and they are very difficult to handle. Now our grated potatoes are ready. I will add grated ginger, chopped chilies and chopped onion, chopped coriander, salt, red chilies, 2 spoons of corn flour. I'll make a nice dough with the hand. We have to mix them together. Now you can see the mash is ready, and we will apply oil on the hand and we'll start making the patties. First, I will divide it into small portions. So I'm applying oil on my hand and I will divide it into equal portions, small balls. To make the stuffing, we are taking about 250 grams of mince of meat. I'm taking mutton mince. Then I'm taking 1 brain of goat. I have blanched it in turmeric and thoroughly cleaned it. Then I will take about 3 boiled eggs. I will chop and mix it into the mixture. Then we will need spices, 1 teaspoon of cumin, 1 teaspoon of red chilies, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, about 1/2 teaspoon of dry mango powder, 1/2 teaspoon of chaat masala, about 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, chopped ginger, 4-5 chilies finely chopped, salt to taste, 3 medium sized onion chopped, and coriander. We will be needing oil for frying. Now we will make the stuffing. Oil, once the oil is hot, we will drop in the cumin, chopped ginger, chopped onion. Saute it till the onion becomes translucent. As you can see, our onion is translucent. I will drop in the mince of meat and saute it. A white lump formation. As you can see, the mince of meat is changing the color from pink or red to white. Now I will add coriander powder, some red chili powder, some chaat masala, some dry mango powder. Remember, we don't want to keep the stuffing overpowering flavored. We want it mildly flavored. Add salt to your taste. Very little amount of garam masala. Once your mince of meat is slightly cooked, drop in the brain. You can chop it, you can mash it, but I will keep it chunky, so I will chop it into small pieces and I will drop it in. And we need a very dry, we don't want it to be liquidy. As you can see, the water has evaporated from the keema and keema is almost done. Now it's time to add the brain. I will chop it up and I will add to it. I have chopped the brain into chunks. Now I will drop it into the mince that was prepared. I will cook it slowly now. Now you can see the brain and the keema is mixed. We will cover it up and cook it for a while. This one is almost done. We'll cook it for a while and then we will add chopped boiled eggs to it and our stuffing is ready. Stuffing is ready now. I will add the chopped boiled eggs and I will also drop in, mash the egg white and I will add to it. It would disguise it as a brain. Now the stuffing is ready. Now we'll do the stuffing. So we need a very thin cover and lots of stuffing in it. So I am rolling it up and I will make a well kind of thing and I will put the stuffing inside it. Stuffing should not be excess or less. So we will make a nice ball out of it. Now we are going to fry these patties. So I have oil here for frying. It's almost hot. So I will take the patty, press it softly, cover it with corn flour or brush off extra corn flour and I will dip it into the egg, strain off the extra egg that is there and I will cover it with breadcrumbs. I will drop this into the oil. Now our patty is golden brown. We will take it off from the pan and drain off the excess oil. I hope you like the recipe. We will meet here again at Coquina. Till then, bye bye and happy cooking.